Bill, I understand you have a special guest with you.
Yeah, Brett, good evening from the airport here at Port-au-Prince. Wyclef Jean, Haitian-born, along with his wife and family. This is Haiti's version of Bono. This is Haiti's version of Bruce Springsteen. He means so much to the people here. How'd you spend your day today?
I mean, it's the best way I can say it is this is apocalypse. The reality that you're getting at the airport has nothing to do with what's going on in the ground right now. We're talking about there's people that's still under the rubble. The count is not 100,000. There's at least has to be 400,000 to 500,000 people that is about to die.
It's an extraordinary figure. Yes. And frankly, we've stayed away from those numbers because they've been high and low. They've been up and down.
Well, I'm telling you, I'm on the ground. Yeah. It's high. The numbers are high. We're talking about we need a state of emergency.
I'm not arguing with you. What I'm trying to figure out is how you spent your day, because it was harrowing for you. And your wife.
We spent the day picking up dead bodies all day. That's what we did, from kids. It's so much bodies in the streets that the morgues are filled up, the cemeteries are filled up. So we participated in picking up the bodies with Kino and finding a place where we could put these bodies. I got to tell you, I have a strong woman. I don't know how she did it, man.
How'd you do it?
I have a choice. I'm doing okay.
You say you didn't have a choice?
We had no other choice, because as soon as we walk in, that's all we saw was pretty much a lot of dead bodies in the street. Kids, so many people underneath. We had more bodies underneath the stone of all them houses that break down than we have live bodies right now.
I know you're trying to raise money.
Yeah, we.
How can people help your country?
People can help right now our country by texting. You're going to text the word YELE. YELE. 501-501 cent. We have to raise $1 million a day. On 4 to 5 days, this whole country is going to be in chaos. We are calling for a state of emergency. Please, President Obama, Secretary of State, Hillary Clinton, the 4 million diaspora Haitians, we have to do something for this country.
My best to you, okay?
Thank you. I know it's
a tough time. I can feel it in your voice when we were talking earlier, Good luck, okay?
Thank you so much.
Brett, there is a bit of good news. Thank you very much. You as well. A bit of good news. About a half an hour ago, the airport lights came on here. Why is that significant? It's generator power, but it enables the runways to stay hot after dark. It's the first night in 3 nights now that they'll be able to fly planes in and out over the overnight hours because they have runway lights here in Port-au-Prince. It is not much, but it is a sliver of good news here. And Port-au-Prince. Back to you, Brett.
Bill, fantastic job, and our best to Wyclef Jean and his wife. Quick question for people who are curious. The reporters out there, where are you all staying during all of this?
We got very little sleep. Thank you very much. Be well. We got very little sleep last night. We're still up here, guys. We're still hot. Sorry about that, Brett. I apologize. Slept on the floor, basically. Look, Haiti's a tough country, man. It is, on a good day, it's tough. And you can imagine right now, in one of the poorest countries in the world, right there with Afghanistan and Somalia and Yemen, a country that has nothing, no power, no telephone communication lines. It's a scene of devastation. And I think what folks at home need to understand, based on what we've seen here locally, is the sheer numbers will blow your mind. It's not a couple dozen on a street corner, it's hundreds or thousands of people. And that scene's repeated everywhere throughout the capital city, Brett.
Yeah, Bill Hemmer live in Port-au-Prince. Bill, stay safe. Thank you very much. Amazing reporting. And again, our best to Wyclef.